Now on four, not a dry eye in the house. Brace yourself for a momentous morning. Out with a bang, it's the very last Big Breakfast.
Welcome to the Big Breakfast. That's Harry and the Playboys over there. And I'm Richard Bacon.
I am Amanda Byron.
And obviously, this is a momentous occasion, a very special day for us. No, not the last show. Today, we're celebrating our 10th birthday a bit early. As one, say happy birthday.
Happy birthday!
And impressionist John Coulshaw. Has Tom Baker got anything to say about this day?
Oh, yes, birthday greetings a little early to the large breakfast. Yes, that's what he would say.
Thank you very much. All right, listen, an extraordinary show today. It's a three-hour special. We're until 10. It is going to be the best show that we've ever done. All sorts of people here today, including Zig and Zag.
It's also your chance to vote for your favourite Big Breakfast clips, the director's cut, the stuff that no one's really seen before. There is Lisa Rogers in the phone room with her team.
Morning. Okay. Morning. No. Bye, sell.
It's a two-camera show today. I have a digital camera.
Oh, you've got your own.
And I've got another camera because essentially I've pulled out all the stops. One may fail.
But did you buy them yourself?
Yes, I did. They cost me a lot of money, but I do earn quite a bit. Now, we've also. What are you doing,
I've
woman?
I've got my clipboard for the last time.
Okay, we've also got this lot! Hello! Settle down! Listen. Shut up now! I'm trying to talk! Please! Loads to deliver. It's great. Thank you for coming down. We've already got about 500 people here this morning, and there are more on the way. Later on, there'll be a full garden. There's lots of celebrity guests, all sorts of people, and I know that you're terrifically excited, particularly Natasha over here. You can say, don't run away, woman. Yes. Have a look at her face. There you can see a rosy glow. Now, I imagine this the biggest day of your life. Am I right?
Yes.
And I know that goes for all 500 people. Get back in there, woman.
Oh my God, but I've dropped my clipboard. What am I going to do? Thank you, Catherine. Here's what's coming up on this morning's Big Breakfast.
Okay.
Oh, they can hear me outside still. Look. Next, Richard's taking a look at the top stories from today's newspaper.
Hey. Okay. Including, I'm still on the PA, including news of slave nurses. Also, 7:10, we have a special surprise guest. He's going to take charge of one of two outside broadcasts that we have on the show today. That's a good scene.
That's right. Then at 7:15, Zig and Zag will be mingling live with the stars.
All right. Zig and Zag up there. Obviously, you were here for the first show. I imagine you're thrilled and excited to be here for the last. Okay, I don't think they can hit. That nodding they were doing means yes we are. Also, a number of big names here, and I can't list them all now, but I can certainly point some stars at the bill. John Coulshaw, Richard Wiley is here.
Oh, yeah! And, Penny from Big Brother's here.
She's in the corner, Matt. She's in the corner. Now, Matt, she's there. There. You can't recognise her. She doesn't look like a man anymore. That's why you couldn't find her. Anyway, listen, gotta go to the news.
Listen, welcome everybody. But right now, here's Jasmine Lowson with the Big Breakfast news and weather.
Thank you, good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 29th of March. Israel declares war on Arafat. Where's Millie? Police chase new leads. And there's no delight over Turkish away. Israeli Prime Minister Ariel Sharon has called Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat the enemy and has called up 20,000 reserve soldiers. This morning, Israeli tanks began shelling Arafat's headquarters in Ramallah. Witnesses say several Palestinians have been injured while Israeli soldiers are under heavy fire. It follows a suicide bomb in Netanya that killed 20 and comes after Mr. Arafat announced he was ready to work for a ceasefire. A short time ago, the Israeli Prime Minister promised to eliminate what he called Arafat's terrorist regime.
We regard Chairman Arafat as an enemy because he decided about strategy of terror and formed a coalition of terror.
Police hunting missing schoolgirl Amanda Dowler are following up dozens of new leads after a TV appeal. One caller may have found the 13-year-old's white purse. Detectives say it could be a major breakthrough. Millie hasn't been seen for more than a week after leaving a train station at Walton-on-Thames in Surrey. Police conducted a routine search of her parents' house and backyard. They admit they no longer believe she ran away. The big Easter getaways got off to a terrible start. Four motorists died in motorway smashes, causing queues of up to 15 miles. Strikes by staff at Manchester Airport and Arriva Trains Northern haven't helped the situation. Your best bet is staying in and tucking into a nice chocolate egg. And if you do go on the road, please drive carefully. Here's England's Euro 2004 qualifier against Turkey is already causing problems 18 months before kickoff. Following the brutal murder of two Leeds fans in Turkey 2 years ago, there are fears that England supporters may be prevented from travelling to the fixture. The FA are set to meet security advisers in Istanbul to decide a solution. It emerged last night that while league football fights for survival, the chief executive of the Football League was sunning himself in Florida. This news will not be welcome at Nottingham Forest and Norwich, who are reported to be close to folding. And Swindon fans will be showing ITV's Cash Cow the Digit after their club went into administration only one day after the digital channel. Here's the weather. Temperatures should range from 9 degrees in Tain to 15 in Sudbury Town. Expect a cool start and bear in mind it may be foggy. And a little rain in Scotland will make it soggy. For most of us, the sun will stay and play for the rest of the day. Here's the five-day forecast. In Scotland and Northern Ireland, there's little but showers to feed up those springtime flowers. Northern and central regions will have a mixture with rain becoming more and more of a fixture. And the south will get it in the mouth with regular showers from Sunday. That's all for now. I'll have more at 7:30.
There's been an incident, everybody. Oh. Richard has wet the floor. He's knocked the vase over.
Right, thanks very much. By the way, later on the show, Johnny Vegas is here later, and he... he's entertaining the crowds in the garden, which I think is good news. And Lucy Benjamin is here as well. Oh, and she gets married in EastEnders tonight. All right, let's have a look at the headlines for the final time. And we'll start over there, Danny. Hello. You're all right, mate. Danny Dyer is here. Let's start on the Daily Mirror. And here we go, a special award they've started. Win a Naomi they have there.
Oh, really?
That is one award that will make Halle Berry cry. I do like the little symbol bit. Thank you. It says look, she's holding a cheque there. Have a look at that. For £3,500. Naomi wouldn't crawl out of rehab for that much. Also down there, the headline today. Vanessa, is it you all right there?
Yeah. Hi, thank you.
Were you Vanessa Francis? Lovely to have you here. The headline, I've got to sit down. The headline on the Mirror, the main headline, is the slave nurses.
Shocker.
I was quite excited.
Quite kinky.
I was quite excited when I first saw it. I thought they were serialising a new Jackie Collins book.